Good morning, friends. In our previous discussion, we have discussed about the helical gear design. Today, we will discuss about the barrel gear design. Before we start, let's have a basic concepts. Which are used in designing of the bevel gears. Bevel gears are used for shaft having an angle. It means it can be used for transmitting the power if the shafts are having an angle. Pitch surfaces of bevel gear are frustum of cone. It means they are generated on the frustum of a cone. As we know that in our previous discussion, spur gear and helical gear, spur and helical gears are generated on a cylindrical surfaces. In this barrel gear, elements of barrel gear and shaft axis must intersect at point. This is very important. Aspects when we are designing our bevel gears, let us having a look. If we are considering that this is a first bevel gear, the teeth are cut on this conical surfaces, that's why we can say the pitch surfaces of the bevel gears are the frustum of the cone. And if the another gear, bevel gear attached to this, and this is the line of second gear. If this is our first gear and this is our second gear, then according to this, that element of the bevel, it means this is the element of the bevel, conical surface or slant surface, and the axis of the shaft, this is the axis of the shaft, they all must intersect at this point, O point. This is the required conditions for the bevel gear. Now, if we are considering that this angle, and this angle is your pitch angle, this angle is also a pitch angle, but this is for gear first, that's why it is a theta P1 and it is a theta P2. That's why in this we are considering this theta P1 is the pitch angle of gear first. Theta P2 is your pitch angle of gear second. Then this total angle is the theta S. This total is the theta S between these two shafts. And this angle is known as the shaft angle. And according to your figure, that it is clear that it should be theta P1 plus theta P2. Fourth aspect of basic concept is the various types of the bevel gear which we are using. It means the types. What are the various types we are using? First is the gear, bevel gear which we are using is known as the meter gear or meter bevel gear. And in this category, if the two gears having a equal number of teeth and equal pitch angle and used for perpendicular shafts, then we can say the gear, bevel gear is the meter gear. It means in this case the theta S should be your 90 degree and theta P1 should be your theta P2 and number of the teeth if we are considering this theta P for pinion and theta Z for gear. If this condition is satisfied, then we can say it is a meter bevel gear. If we are giving another type tank, it is known as the angular bevel or angle bevel gear. In this angular bevel gear, if the shaft angle is less than 90, then we can say it is an angular bevel gear. Crown bevel gear. In this crown bevel gear, if this theta S is greater than 90 degree and one of the metal gear having pitch angle equal to 90 degree. If this situation is satisfied, then we can say it is a crown bevel gear. If you are considering that this is our gear, this is the line of this gear first, it means this gear having a this line and another gear having a this axis line, this is the axis line, and we know that this is your second bevel gear. If this type of the situation is there, it means the total angle is your theta S, which is greater than 90 degree, and in which one of them having a theta P1 and one of them having a theta P2. It means theta S is greater than 90 degree and one of them, let us considering this theta P1, is your 90 degree. If this condition is satisfied, then we can say it is a crown bevel gear. And internal bevel gear, if the teeth are cut on internal side of the cone, then we can say it is a internal bevel gear. These types are very important as per the classification of point of view. Next, we are using the various terms which are used in bevel gear designing. Various terms used in bevel gear designing. And before we defining these various terms, let us having a, if we are considering that this is our pinion, and this is the center line of this, and this point is known as the pitch point. And if you are considering that this is our pinion, and for this pinion, this distance is known as the PCD of this pinion, and this distance, we are considering this distance, then this distance is known as the addendum of this, or outer diameter of this pinion. If considering that this is our pitch point, then this distance is addendum and this distance is your dedendum D, A and D. And if you are considering that this pinion having a pitch angle which is your theta P1, and this is the intersection of this O, let us considering this O is the intersection of this, this point is also P. That's why we are considering this OP. And if the another gear which is a gear and attached to this, then this is the another gear, and if we are considering that this is our another gear attached to this, attached to this, and let us considering that this is the pitch point of this. That's why if you are considering that this is pinion and this is gear, then for this gear this distance is the PCD of this, and we are considering that this is the DZ for this, and this is the outer diameter for this. And we are considering this outer diameter or addendum for the gear. And the angle, pitch angle for this is, let us considering this is the theta P2. It means this theta P2 for the gear. If this is our in mating of the two bevel gear, then this slant distance of this cone OP is also known as the cone distance. It means this OP is your cone distance. Now if you find the various terms, then the first term which we are using is your cone distance, which we have termed as the OP, or in some of books it is also used for our design purpose, L. Now we are considering the triangle or finding out of this. If we are considering that this is your OP and this is the line, if we are considering that this is our OP, this is the line, then drawing a horizontal line from this, and let us considering it will intersect at this O dash, and we know that this angle is your theta P1, and we know that this angle is your radius of this. This is the radius, that's why it is the dp by 2, and we can say it is the dp by 2. Now if we want to find out a relationship, a trigonometrical relationship for this, then we can say sin theta p1 is equal to your, if you are considering this perpendicular base, perpendicular, hypotenuse base, sin cos 10, cos x quad, then for sin, perpendicular upon hypotenuse, the perpendicular means the in front distance of this, opposite distance of this is the perpendicular, this is our base and this is our hypotenuse, that's why perpendicular upon hypotenuse is equal to your dp by 2 upon hypotenuse is your OP is equal to this, that's why the OP which is equal to also L is given by this dp divided by sin theta p1. This is very important relationship which is used for designing purpose. Now if you are considering for this pinion, then this length is the in terms of the pinion, but if you are considering that in terms of this OP, in terms of this gear also, it is the same distance. That's why if you are using for this, then this OP may also be given by this relationship upon sin theta P2. If you are considering for this pinion, then the angle for pinion is used and the diameter of the pinion is used. If you are considering for the gear, then this is used for the gear. The cone distance, and after this cone distance, now we can define the addendum angle. If you are considering that this is our pitch point, then above the pitch is the addendum and below the pitch is the addendum. That's why this is the pitch line, this is the addendum, and this is our addendum or root. If you are considering that this angle is the alpha and this angle is the beta angle, then for finding out this addendum angle and addendum angle, we are using this. If we are considering that in a large section of this, this is our O, this is our P, that is, we are considering that this is your Q and this is your R, and we know that this angle is the alpha angle and this angle is the beta angle, and this is your addendum A and this is your addendum D. That's why if we want to find out the addendum angle, then addendum angle, which is your alpha, or in terms of this trigonometrical relationship, we can find out in terms of tan alpha. Then from this triangle OPQ, by applying the trigonometrical relationship for tan alpha perpendicular upon base, this is our perpendicular, this is our base. From this relationship, tan alpha is perpendicular upon base, and this is our perpendicular and this is our base. That's why this is equal to your A upon base is your OP. Now we have the value of this OP from here. By putting this, we can find out the value of this addendum and also the addendum angle. Now in this case, the addendum angle is your beta. That's why by tan beta. Now from this triangle OPR, by applying the same trigonometric relationship, perpendicular upon base, this is the perpendicular and this is the base. That's why addendum upon OP. By the help of this, we can calculate the addendum angle and addendum angle. Another terms which we are using in our design also, which is known as the addendum diameter or addendum diameter. And for finding out this addendum and addendum diameter, let's we are considering this. We know that if we are considering this for a pinion, then this distance for the pinion is your dp. Total distance is dp. And if we have a addition of this distance both the sides, then we can calculate the outside diameter, or if we subtract from both the sides, then we can calculate the addendum. It means if we want to find out the addendum and addendum, then we have this dp and we have to find out the component of this resolution of this pq on this, that side. Now finding the angle for this, if we are considering this, and we know that for this center line angle, this angle is your theta p, this is 90, then this is your 90 minus theta p. That's why this angle is your theta p1 and this angle is also a theta p1. If this angle is the theta p1, then the resolution of this pq on this is your a cos theta p1. It means this component is your a cos theta p1, and both the sides this component is added. That's why we can calculate the value of this addendum and addendum. Now the addendum is equals to your pitch circle plus, because there is an addition of both the sides of this, then the twice of A into cos theta P1. And if we want to calculate this addendum, then this is equals to your dp, then minus subtraction from this component, and this component is also a, if this angle and this angle is equal, then this in terms of d, that's why we can say twice into d into cos theta p1. From this relationship, we can calculate the addendum diameter or addendum diameter with the help of this PCDs. Another concept which we are using in this, which is known as the formative number of the teeth. This is also a important parameter for designing formative number of the teeth, or it is also known as the equivalent number of teeth. As per our previous video, in our helical gear design, we have also discussed that this formative number of the teeth for the helical gear, that in this case the formative number of the teeth, which is the T equivalent, which equals to your true value of the teeth divided by cos of the pitch circle. Now if we are using for this a pinion, then we are using equivalent number for the pinion, then the true value for the pinion, then theta 1 for the pinion. And if we are using this equivalent for a gear, then true value for the gear and cos theta pitch angle for the gear. And we know that for gear it is a theta p2, that's why putting this theta p2. In some of books or in some of cases, we can also say this is equal to your in terms of the sec theta p1. That's why we can use in terms of sec also, or in terms of the cos components. This is our formative number of the teeth, which are very important for our design purpose. In the last points which we are using in our terms of the bevel gear is the, how can we identify the pitch angle for any given number of this meshing of the gears, and if we want to find out the angle for this, then this should be equal to your sine theta s upon velocity ratio plus cos theta s. In this theta p1 is your pitch angle for the pinion, theta s is your shaft angle, vr is your velocity ratio, and we know that the velocity ratio is given by this tg upon tp, or t is directly proportional to the dia. That's why by the help of this velocity ratio and shaft angle, we can find out the first angle, and also by having this, we can find out the pitch angle for another or gear, which is equal to your 1 upon Vr plus cos theta s. By the help of this relationship, we can calculate firstly this theta s is given, then for this theta s, calculate this theta p1 and theta p2, then the various terms can be calculated. So friends, this is all about our the basic concept for the bevel gear design. In our next video, we will discuss the procedure of bevel gear design. Thank you.